So we are starting with a new topic. The topic we will discuss today is called dimensionality reduction. And the idea here is basically that we will learn about techniques that will later become very handy when we will talk about recommender systems, and in particular, latent factor recommender systems. So let me give you an idea of what the problem of dimensionality reduction is all about. So basically, our assumption is that we have a set of data points. Think of them as points in a plane or points in a three-dimensional space. And the idea is that these points are not just randomly scattered through this space, but they lie in a subspace of it. So for example, here I have two cases of this. You could imagine that you have a set of data in a two-dimensional plane, but the data is not really kind of randomly scattered through this plane, but it is only scattered across a small subspace of it. So for example, in the first case, we have the data points that are embedded on this particular line. So maybe a more better representation of this data is not in this two-dimensional space, but it's basically just where in the length of the line is a given data point. Or for example, in the second case, we are drawing a case where we have points embedded in a three-dimensional space, but again, these points are not randomly scattered through this space, but basically they all lie on this single plane that is embedded in this space. So basically the idea for us is, can we go and discover such data representations, right? So if I give you an arbitrary set of data, can we identify what are the main axes along which the data is represented or embedded? So in particular, in this second case, we have these two red axes where all the data lies. So our goal in some sense will be that we want to find a subspace that is effectively represents all the data that we are given. So let me just give you a concrete example, right? So our goal in a sense will be that we want to compress or reduce the dimensionality or the size of the data representation. So the way we can think of this is that we are given a big table with a large number of rows, let's say millions of rows, and also a large number of columns. And what we can think of this kind of table is that every row represents a different data point, and every column represents a different coordinate or a different dimension. And our goal is that we take this set of data and identify a kind of more compact or fewer dimensional representation. So in a sense, we would like to keep all the rows, but we would like to shrink the number of columns while still preserve the richness of the data set. So for example, let's look at the table that I have here. I have, for example, a table where every row is a different customer and every column is a different time of the day, where every entry stores how many of particular transactions or particular products did a particular customer buy. And for example, what we see in this particular case is that even though we have five different days, so five different columns, our data is not really in some sense five-dimensional, but it's only two-dimensional. What do I mean by this is that, for example, all the first four rows and the first three columns, they're basically all just multiplications of one another, right? So in some sense, I have a set of customers that all buy products in the first three columns, and they do nothing on the last two, and then I have another set of, let's say, customers that they all make transactions over the weekends and they don't do anything over the week, right? So in some sense, rather than representing every customer now with a set of five values, I can simply represent this data with a set of two coordinate vectors plus a value of which class, in some sense, which dimension or which cluster it belongs to, right? So for example, this matrix that I just showed you is really two-dimensional, where every row is simply a multiplication of one of the two vectors of ones and zeros. So basically, the idea for us will be, can we identify this kind of low-level representation of data? So let me explain a concept that will be very important for us to think about this, right? So we are thinking that our data comes in a form of a matrix, right? So we can think of matrix basically as every line giving us coordinates of a point in some d-dimensional space. So we have our data point, we have some number of data points, and we have some number of columns, which is corresponds to the dimensionality of the data. And now the question is, what is the real intrinsic dimensionality to that data set? And the concept we need to explain is the concept of a rank of a matrix. And we will say that the rank of a matrix A is simply the number of linearly independent columns of A. So let me give you an example. So for here is an example. You consider the matrix A that has three rows and three columns, and the rank of this matrix equals 2. Why is the rank of this matrix equal to 2? Is because it has two linearly independent rows in this case. What do we notice, for example, is that that the row number 3 is simply the sum of rows 1 and 2. So the third row of this matrix can be represented as a linear combination of rows 1 and 2. So in this case, our matrix is really two-dimensional. Even I have data in three dimensions, I have three columns, this matrix is really two-dimensional. So how can we think about this is the following. I can basically think that there are really like two basis vectors or two coordinate vectors in my space. First one corresponds to the first row, second one corresponds to the second row, and then what I can do now is I can represent every data point as a linear combination of these two vectors. So for example, the first row can simply be represented as a vector of 1 and 0, which means that I only take the first vector and I take 0 of the second vector. For example, the second row of my matrix A can be represented now as a vector of 0, 1, because I'm only taking the second of my two basis vectors. And for example, the last row, which is the sum of the rows 1 and 2, can be simply represented as with a vector 1, 1. So why is this intuition interesting? This intuition is important because I can think of now data as being some points in high dimensional space. I can think of the data being represented as a matrix, where, as I mentioned before, every data point is a row in this matrix and every column is a separate dimension. And what I can do now, I can think of this as doing dimensionality reduction, right? So for example, if I'm given the matrix on the top, I can basically take and rewrite the coordinates of these points instead of using three coordinates, using only two coordinates. Right, so if I use my original coordinate space, where basically I have axis-aligned vectors that describe coordinates of my space, so I have a 1 and then two zeros, and a 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1, so this is x, y, and z coordinate, then in this coordinate system, every data point simply corresponds to the row of my matrix. But what I can also do is I can come and invent a new coordinate system. Imagine I invent the second one, where I only have two vectors. So basically, I want to represent every data point with two coordinates. And what this means is that I want to represent every data point as a linear combination of the two vectors. And as I mentioned before, now in this new coordinate space, I can represent the coordinates of every point using only two values, right? And I can still reconstruct the original coordinate values. So what does this really mean is, in some sense, that we reduced the dimensionality, or we compressed the data in a sense that now I need a fewer number of coordinates to describe the location of every point, right? And this is what the role of dimensionality reduction is. So really, the way we can think of dimensionality reduction is that we have a set of data points embedded in some high-dimensional space. As in this case, I have the data embedded in two-dimensional space. But really, the data is in high dimensions, but only spans a small dimensional part of it. So as in this case, I have set of points that I'm given in two-dimensional space. But in reality, these points simply fall on a line. And I would like to discover that these points are embedded in a small subspace, and I would like to represent now or compress the dimensionality of every point to this small coordinate subspace. And what is important here, for example, in this particular case, is that I can now think of representing the coordinate of every point using kind of two dimensions. I can represent their position along the red line, and I can represent it with a coordinate that tells me how far away from the red line is a given data point. And what is interesting now is that I can say that instead of representing still using two coordinates, I could only represent using one coordinate. So meaning I would forget about how far from the red line a point lies, and I would only care about the location on the red line where the point can be projected. And this way I would be able to represent every point with a single number, basically the position of it along the red line, and I would incur a bit of an error. Right, so what we will be doing is we will be, in some sense, trying to use as small a representation of our data as possible, so as few coordinates as possible, while also incurring as little error as possible. Right, so the game we will be playing is between having a smaller data representation while also trying to incur as little error as possible. So the way we will do this and why we would want to do this is the following, right? Why would I want to do the dimensionality reduction? So the first thing is I would want to, for example, discover hidden correlations in my data. In some sense, I would like to discover really the latent dimensions along which the data varies. So this is particularly useful if I think of my data as my points. I think of them as documents, right? So I can take every document, represent it as a very long vector, where this vector has only values 0 and 1, where 0 means a given word, you know, the kth word does not appear in the document, and 1 means that the word appears in the document. And my goal, for example, would be to identify what are the axes along which the documents are spread in this all possible words kind of space. And what we would find out is that here documents basically align themselves along different axes that correspond to topics like sports, politics, technology, and so on. Another useful thing that we would want to do is, for example, many times we can take a large data set and represent it as a much smaller data set, in some sense that basically we are able to remove or get rid of noisy features or noisy columns, because there our data is not varying too much, so we can kind of get rid of that part of the data while still preserving most of it. So this is the idea, in some sense, to do remove noise from the data, to remove noisy and redundant features or noisy and redundant columns. Another way why we may want to do this is that we want to, for example, be able to interpret or visualize our data. What this means is that we can have very high dimensional data, and we can reduce the dimensionality of it maybe just to 2 or 3 dimensions. And plotting 2 or 3 dimensions is very easy, right? We can kind of plot it on the screen. So that's another case. And of course, one important application is that many times we want to reduce dimensionality of the data so that kind of the data size also shrinks, which means it's easier to store, process, and analyze the data afterwards, right? So these are all the reasons why I would want to, in some sense, find a lower dimensional representation of a given set of data.